Hi, I'm Rick Emerson. Welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. We're talking with Mr. Dave Howell. He is the CEO of Avatron Software. We were talking about Air Display, which is your company's most recent success, and it lets you use a handheld device as a secondary computer monitor, and this was something that solved a personal irritation or annoyance for you. And that must be a great moment as a creator or an inventor when you have the knowledge in an overarching sense of how something works and how this technology operates, and then you have a problem that needs solving, and the two sort of merge together at one moment. You say, I know exactly how we can do this. You mentioned having different categories for things. We had ideas that were impossible. What is an idea that was impossible, if you don't mind telling me, that that you might revisit in the future, or something that you would like to make possible?
A lot of them were app concepts that either required some hardware, so it wasn't possible for us. It's just not economically feasible to start having to worry about things like inventory and supply chains and all that stuff we were so happy to be away from. Other things were prohibited by the app SDK or by the hardware limitations itself. But there is so much within the realm of what is allowed and what is possible that we had no shortage of app ideas there.
Actually, so Colin, who's behind the camera right now, has an app for his iPhone that will replicate the look of various handheld still cameras from different eras, 50s to 60s, so you can get that 70s washed out look. If you want, you can get the 50s, sort of, if you have like a Browning camera, which is the sort of thing that seems simple and basic, but the simple basic things are often the things that are the best because they address a specific need and they do one thing very well. Is that the future, in your opinion, of computing, or of the way that computing will develop? Small specialized programs or devices that are created perhaps almost independently and then go to market, as opposed to coming from massive conglomerates?
Well, I think that's Apple's strategy, to induce us to make apps that are small compartmentalized things. They regularly feature things that do one thing really well. And I think they're afraid of another Adobe or another Microsoft coming up with a powerful suite that can kind of control Apple's destiny. So you see a lot of single purpose apps really well designed around that one purpose, as opposed to big monolithic apps.
As opposed to bloatware.
That too.
And you know, I just say as a personal aside, I'm really grateful that nothing I've ever purchased for my Mac has a paperclip that comes up on the screen and seems to lecture me about how I'm writing a letter. It appears you're trying to be productive. Can I stop that? I'm sorry. You see apps sometimes, you mentioned that they do one specific thing. Sometimes they do one specific thing that is also unbelievably silly. I was at a Jonathan Colton show a while back, and when he went to intermission, it was immediately the sound of about 500 iPhone lightsabers going as guys, wow, it's kind of weird how well I do that. It's hard to believe I'm married. For somebody who wants to create a lightsaber, which maybe is a bad example because there's, you know, Lucasfilm and trademarks and so forth, but the guy that just has the idea, how much does it cost to get that from idea to creation? Somebody told me $2,000, and I don't know if that's too high, if it's too low. I have no idea what that costs.
Well, something that has minimal programming in it, you could probably do in $2,000. But really, I mean, if you're paying somebody $150 an hour to write code, that's only 10 hours of programming plus $500 worth of maybe a photographer's time. So it goes pretty fast. We spend 10 times that amount just having our app description localized into 13 languages.
Wow.
So, you know, the budgets are pretty high for app development.
We're talking with Mr. Dave Howell from Avatron Software. When we come back, I will continue to make embarrassing lightsaber noises. Not really. You're watching Outlook Portland right here on Northwest 32 TV. Stay there.